here at the Secret Chevy Shop, and I wanted to show you guys a quick video on the 63 Tempest rear end, or transaxle. What's really cool about this thing is this kind of goes to show the fertile imagination at General Motors in the early 60s. If this strikes you as a very Corvair-esque part, you're absolutely correct, because the Y-body, which is the early Tempest, Corvair, and the F-85 Oldsmobile, are all the same chassis, so a lot of these parts look similar. In fact, John Z. DeLorean, who later became known for the GTO and even the Back to the Future Time Machine DeLorean, was the brainchild. He was a brainchild that came up with this thing. Now, if you look at this, look at how there's a torque converter just hanging on the outside of this thing. That's because the Tempest was originally supposed to be a rear-engine car, much like the Corvair. Now, if you go back to your history books, we all know that in 1949, the Volkswagen in America was a total sales flop with only two being imported. In 1950, you started seeing a lot more, but by the early 60s, those little rear-engined, independent, suspensioned imports were taking the world by storm, and General Motors took notice. Now, what's really interesting, too, is you got to think about this. If you take a look at this rear end here, this is your live axle rear end. This has been basically the de facto rear end since you could even make live rear ends. I mean, I think chain drive was pretty much abandoned by the early teens, by World War I, and they started using design like this. Now, Europe came about and started doing a lot with independent rear cars. Mercedes-Benz, for instance, is one I can think of. Now, Tucker actually had a sort of independent rear end in its transaxle. It had the Tours Elastic biscuits, but it actually was a modified, the Tucker transaxle was actually a modified Cordell 29 unit. So that's kind of not really, I can't really consider it one of the first independent rear suspension cars. There's also the Dubonnet Dauphine of 1935, which is more French, but it actually had a Ford V8, flathead Ford V8 for power. But again, this is pretty much it right here. And this is only, I want to say, I only thought it was 63, but according to Wikipedia, it was 61 to 63. I'm sure someone out there in YouTube land can tell me more about it. But you can actually see how the transaxle itself was originally intended to be with, you know, to be rear-engined. Now, Crown did this very similar conversion with their Crown Corvair mid-engine V8s, did the exact same concept. And this is just a pretty unique piece of engineering. Anyway, there you go. There's your Kelly's Cars Old School USDM Hunter trivia for the day here at the Secret Chevy Shop in a land far, far away.